Welcome to the session Ambiguity in Context-Free Grammar. I am Ajay Lora. In the earlier session, we had discussed the design of context-free grammar. In this session, we will discuss leftmost derivation, rightmost derivation, and ambiguity in context-free grammar. Let's start the session. In context-free grammar, production rules are of the form A will give you alpha, and alpha is any string over terminal and non-terminal. There is no restriction on number of non-terminal used in the right-hand side. If more than one non-terminal appear in the right-hand side of a production rules, then grammar is known as non-linear grammar. Now suppose we have given a non-linear grammar, then the derivation of a string W from the initial non-terminal S involves two or more non-terminal at one or more places in the derivation of a string W. If we will generate a string W from S somewhere in the middle, we will find out two or more non-terminal in one or more places in the derivation of string W. If at each step of the derivation of string W we will expand the leftmost non-terminals, then the derivation is known as a leftmost derivation. For example, S will give you AB and we will expand A, suppose it by AAB. Now we again have two options, whether to expand A or B, and again we will expand A first. Then again we have two options for generating a string W. If we have two or more options of expanding the non-terminals, and if we expand the leftmost non-terminal at each time, then the derivation is known as leftmost derivation. Similarly, if at each step of the derivation of string W we expand the rightmost non-terminal, then the derivation is known as rightmost derivation. Now consider the context-free language L, A, N, B, N, C, M, D, M for N and M greater than equal to 0. First, we will design context-free grammar for the language L. So the language L can be divided into L1, L2, and L can be defined by concatenation of L1 with L2. We can write down a production rule for L will give you L1, L2 is, S will give you AB. Then A is used to generate language L1 and B is used to generate L2. So using A, we will generate equal number of A followed by equal number of B, and using B, a number of C followed by equal number of D. Now this is context-free grammar for language L. Now for string W, AA, BB, CD, we will generate the leftmost derivation. So S will give you AB. Now we have two options. We can expand A or B, but A is the leftmost non-terminal, so A is replaced by AAB. Again we have two options, either to expand A or B. If we will expand A again, because we are generating the string using leftmost derivation, so A is replaced by AAB. Again we have two options, but we are using leftmost derivation, so A is replaced by null. Then B is used to generate CBD. Then B is replaced by null and we will get this thing AA, BB, CD. Now in case of rightmost derivation, we will start with non-terminal S. S is replaced by AB. Now we have two options, either we can expand A or B, but because we are using the rightmost derivation, so we will expand B first. So A, CBD. Again we have two options, either to expand A or B, but we are using the rightmost derivation, so we will replace B by null. Now we have a single option, we will replace the non-terminal A by AAB, CD. Again we have a single non-terminal, so we will replace it by AAB. Then we will replace A by null and we will able to generate the required string. Now we will generate the parse tree for leftmost derivation. So S will give you AB, A will give you
AAB. A is then replaced again by AB. A is replaced by null. B is replaced by CBD. Then B is replaced by null. So we have a starting non-terminal S. So starting non-terminal S will be the root node of the parse tree. Non-terminal like AB will appear as the internal node. Symbols from the alphabets like A, B, B, C, D appear as the leaf node. In addition, null can also appear as the leaf node. So we can summarize it as the starting non-terminal will be the root node of the parse tree. We can call it as parse tree or derivation tree. Leaf node can be taken from sigma or it can be null. Internal node or non-terminal. If a non-terminal A will give you A1, A2 up to AM. So we will represent A1, A2, A3 and so on from left to right. We had already discussed the parse tree for leftmost derivation. Now we will discuss the ambiguity in context-free grammar. Ambiguity also exists in natural languages. Like in Hindi language, consider a sentence of Hindi language. Roko, mat jane do. And the another sentence will be Roko, mat jane do. So in the first sentence, we do not want to stop the person, but in the second sentence, we want to stop the person because we are pronouncing it as Roko, mat jane do. So we want to stop the person. So there exists ambiguity in natural languages. Similarly, in formal languages, ambiguity will also occur. Given a grammar G, if there exists a string W, belongs to the language, and we can able to generate either two leftmost derivation or we can able to generate two rightmost derivation, then we will call grammar is ambiguous grammar. We will discuss it by examples. Now consider the grammar E will give you E plus E. E denotes for expression, E multiply E, or ID. ID stand for identifier used in the programming language. Now consider a string W, ID plus ID multiply ID, and if we can able to generate two leftmost derivation or two rightmost derivation, we will call the grammar as ambiguous grammar. So let's start with the non-terminal E, because E is the starting non-terminal. Suppose E is replaced by E multiply E. Then we will expand the leftmost non-terminal. Suppose E is replaced by E plus E. Then we have three options. We can expand the first E, second E or third E, because we are using the leftmost derivation. So we will expand the first E and replace it by ID. Now we have two options. We will expand the leftmost non-terminal. So replace E by ID. Then we will replace E by ID. And we will able to generate the string W. If we replace E by E plus E, then E can be replaced by ID. Then we can able to replace E by E multiply E. Then E can be replaced by ID. Then E can be replaced by ID. So we will able to generate the string. Now we had generated two leftmost derivation for the string W, where W is ID plus ID multiply ID. So we can call this grammar as ambiguous grammar. Now we will draw parse tree for the first derivation. So in the first derivation, we had replaced E by E multiply E. Then first E is replaced by E plus E. Then E is replaced by ID. E is replaced by ID. E is replaced by ID. Similarly, we can able to generate the parse tree for the second derivation. So E will give you E plus E. Then E can give you ID. E can give you E, E multiply E. And then E can be replaced by ID. A grammar is called ambiguous if we can able to generate two leftmost derivation or two rightmost derivation for a particular string that belongs to the language. Now consider another grammar. S will give you 0s, s0 or 0. Now suppose the string w is 000. Now using leftmost derivation, we will check whether the grammar is ambiguous or not. S is replaced by 0s, then s can be replaced by 0s, then s can be replaced by 0. So our parse tree will look like this one: 0s, 0s, then it is replaced by 0. The second option can be like this one: s will give you 0s, then s can be replaced by s0, s can be replaced by 0. So second parse tree or derivation tree will look like this one: 0s, s0 and 0. Similarly, we can have third option also: s can give you s0, then s can be replaced by s0, then s can be replaced by 0, and its corresponding parse tree will look like this one: s0, s0 and s is replaced by 0. The fourth option can be like this one: s0, 0s and s is again replaced by 0. So we had derived the string w using the four leftmost derivation, so we will call the grammar as ambiguous grammar. Now this is the self-assessment question. Consider the grammar g. S will give you 0s1, 01s or null. We need to check whether the grammar is ambiguous or not. So in this particular case, we need to choose a string w for which we can able to generate two leftmost derivation or two rightmost derivation. If we can able to find out a string w that belongs to the language and that satisfy the ambiguity property, we will call the grammar as ambiguous grammar. In the next session, we will discuss how precedence and associativity will be decided using context-free grammar in programming language. Thanks for watching this session.